The video is Leila Nishmas Rishmu Bach and Chayin Slev and a full Shlema to Chayin from Bas Parma Yamalka. Shabbas Shuva. Shabbas that we'd like to return to Hashem. Let's explain what that means. And also, as we mentioned yesterday, of Yonson Ibershitz, who says that this Shabbas, we can fix every single Shabbas of the year. So what does this mean on a practical level? Someone asked me, these 7 days that we called super days, how can we use them and utilize them on a very practical level? So let's understand what we would like the Shabbos to be like. The Shabbos would be like to be the prototype of the entire year. So even though we understand that the entire year, we can't be on our best behavior, so to speak. But this Shabbos, we want to show Hashem that this is the way we'd like the whole year to be. What is this based on? Let's relate a story. I heard this many times from my Rebbe, an amazing story about a Yid that came to Rav Eliyashiv. He was very distraught. He told Rav Eliyashiv that he spent a lot of money, a lot of shkolim. What did he spend a lot of shkolim on? So he explained to him that he's in Yud Beis Chodesh, he's in Avelus for his father. He was very careful never to miss saying Kaddish. And he found himself in outside of Yerushalayim, I think it was in Bnei Brak, it was already quite late, 1, 2 a.m. And he couldn't find a minyan. He didn't know what to do. So he remembered, when you don't know, if you're looking for a minyan, in Yerushalayim there's a famous shul, Zichron Moshe I think it's called. And you know you're going to have a minyan 2, 3, 4 in the morning maybe. So he decided, I can't miss. So he gets a monit, gets into a taxi, spends a lot of shkolim, and Boch Hashem, he gets a minyan, comes back, and he's all proud of himself, and he's very happy, but then he started feeling guilty. Was that the right thing to do? Spend so much shkolim, something that he not necessarily could afford. So the next day he went to Rav Eliyashiv, Zichrono Livracha, and he told him, explained to him how distraught he was, and how he just wasn't sure if he did the right thing. Rav Eliyashiv told him, not only did you do the right thing, every single day of saying Kaddish is now valued on the basis of that amount of shkolim. Meaning to say, by you showing what you're willing to spend when you need to spend for this mitzvah of saying Kaddish for your father, you show that really every single day you'd be willing to do that. And if that means that every single day, then to the Rabbeinu Shem, to Hashem, it's considered each day like you spent 500 shkolim. An amazing idea. Now what that means for us on a practical level is that this Shabbos, what would we like the Shabbos to be the whole year? So maybe we're not always careful to utilize the time and learn and try to really reflect on what our life's all about. Are we living our purpose? Shabbos is a time of reflection. Shabbos is called Main Olam Haba for a reason, because we're supposed to speak about Olam Haba and think about Olam Haba and make sure that we're getting ready. Right? The expression that Chazal uses, Misha Toch Be'er Shabbos, Yochel Be'Shabbos, someone that prepares before Shabbos, excuse me, he's going to be able to enjoy Shabbos. He's going to be able to enjoy Olam Haba. We need to prepare. This world is a place of preparation. So this is my humble suggestion. Whether it's men or women today, everyone needs Musaf. The first and most basic is to make sure that we have 10 minutes a day, and Shabbos is a perfect time because we have more time to read a sefer about life, about ourselves, about making sure that we're really in tune what our purpose in this world is, whether it's a chovas alavavas, mesilas yesham, translations in English, something that really makes us think a little bit more. It is a scary thing. The poskim say that if a person is doing tshuva, but all they're doing is they're saying tehillim and they're davening, but they're really not looking and trying to change their midos, it's, I don't want to say the word, it's almost useless. Because if we're not changing and we're not working on ourselves, and that's what really the Torah is all about, to make sure that we bring about a change upon ourselves. So yes, incredible prayer, tehillim, it's amazing. And for sure, utilize Shabbos for that. But first and foremost is the Musaf Seder, is really what's called the Ashkafa, making sure that we're really real with ourselves. Are we more forgiving? Are we still holding grudges? Did we react during the week to our kids in too much anger? To our friends in too much anger? Do we get upset when someone asks us to do something when, you know, it was an opportunity? And I want to share with you an amazing story. It happened to me. It just happened to me this year. The last moments of Rosh Hashanah. I shared this with the shul. It's even embarrassing, but it's worthwhile because it's so real. So here I am about 20 minutes before, maybe even 10 minutes before licht benching, really, of Rosh Hashanah. I'm trying to answer the last few shailas and maybe prepare myself a little bit for Rosh Hashanah. It's amazing. I get a call from someone that's in charge in the shul of taking care of the svarim. So he puts together the svarim, and he's supposed to take out the machzorim from a certain building, bring it to the shul, and everything will be organized and beautiful. He calls me up and says, sorry, I forgot. And he was calling me twice. Usually I don't even answer if I don't even know the person. I don't always answer if I don't know the name. I pick it up. I said, it must be maybe an emergency. He says, I'm sorry. Can you do it for me? Maybe I get your kids, whatever. And I'm thinking to myself, what? I remember I used to do this when I used to do kiruv. I used to run around like crazy, making sure that there's sidurim and I remember doilies for the ladies and making sure they have cover hairs. And it was straining. It was an amazing experience. But I thought that was it. And now this guy's asking me, so thank God I wasn't mean, but I wasn't excited. I said, okay, I'll take care of it. And then afterwards, when I thought about it, and I started going and I gained the sperm, and I got into the car, and I got my boys to help, and we brought it into the shul. I remember thinking to myself, oh, I blew it. It was an opportunity. Hashem was saying, the last moments of the year, you could help Tzibu, you could help Klal Yisrael, you could help the people in the shul. Why am I not jumping for joy? And you know, you only think about this if you're really working on yourself. So take advantage of this Shabbos. Have an amazing Shabbos.